On day one, we focused on muscles of the front side of your shoulder, which become tight and round forward. On day two, we're focusing on the backside, specifically muscle that becomes tight, preventing you from reaching overhead without discomfort. Let's do some soft tissue work for your lats, which become tight over time spent sitting and pushing. Just like day one, find a pain point where you're experiencing a little tenderness and massage that area for 30 to 60 seconds, oscillating around in little circles. Just like day one, you're only striving for maybe a 4 out of 10 on the pain scale. More will have the opposite effect, causing the muscle to tighten further while protecting itself, rather than loosening and preparing your body for the rest of the warm-up. 30 to 60 seconds on each side, 2 minutes total, and then we're moving on to phase two. Now that we just did some acute soft tissue work on your lats to loosen them up, let's prepare those muscles to move safely by getting relaxed and ready to roll with some dynamic biphasic stretching. Get about a foot away from a table, counter, or shelf, or bench, whatever you got, and lean into a safe and sturdy position which can hold your upper body weight for about a minute. Gently rock in and out with your arms overhead, focusing on breathing through your diaphragm for about 20 seconds. Find your safe end range position and hold the deep stretch for about 15 to 20 seconds. Remember, no further than a 4 out of 10 discomfort, or you're going to create the opposite of the intended effect. About a minute total of this, and we're on to part two. Our corrective exercise on day two is going to focus on shoulder mobility and stability with this overhead Y. And then we're going to create more of a dynamic range of motion with that shoulder blade by taking it through the full snow angel. I want you to begin to feel like you're working a little bit during this warm up. And these Ys and snow angels will get you there. 10 to 12 reps on one side, switch to the other, 10 to 12 reps on the other side, and you should be ready to move on to stage four. As you move through the snow angel, make the movement with intention. As you bring your arm up overhead, I want you to feel your upper trap and your serratus anterior engage. And then as you mindfully bring your arm down, feel your lower trap and your rhomboids, that muscle, that deep muscle between your shoulder blades. I want you to feel that those muscles engage, pulling your shoulder blades down and together. Again, repeat 10 to 15 times before we move on to the next phase. Where we spend so much time with our shoulders working internal rotation, pushing our chairs and sitting with poor posture, we need to be working the little external rotator muscles of our shoulders daily. We just need a light band here, as these tiny muscles don't need to be loaded up with weight to warm up. Pin your elbows to your sides and rotate your hands away from your body as best you can. You'll feel a significant stretch in your internal rotators and maybe get a sense of just how tight those little muscles might actually be. Hold the discomfort, slowly return, and repeat for about 15 reps in about 45 to 60 seconds. Again, be mindful of the muscles externally rotating your shoulders. Those little muscles that tire quickly are the infraspinatus and the teres minor. Our movement pattern prep is taking us through both the pull and the push. These face pulls to overhead press. This is such a great movement because it's working so many different muscles and it's helping with posture as well as with your rotator cuff. As you pull your arm back with the face pull, I want you trying to really be mindful of trying to get your wrist behind your elbow. Okay, that's gonna help really work that rotator cuff a little bit more and prepare you for the overhead press. Try to get 15 reps on both sides before switching to the other, and then we'll move on to the next phase. In the final phase, phase six, we are working on your central nervous system stimulation, okay? And what we are trying to do here on day two, where we've been working on the back muscles, is trying to get you ready for either that home workout of doing a vertical push, or get you ready for whatever activity you're doing throughout the day, okay? So you really want to wake up your nervous system, prepare your shoulders for that day's work by doing 1-2 sets of 3 to 6 reps of just an explosive movement overhead, working through that whole range of motion that you've just spent the last 10 minutes getting ready for. Now that your body is primed and ready to move, you are ready for a pain-free day.